Hello everyone, my name is Jacob Olakunle Ajomale, a Nigerian. I'm making this video because of a microchip that was forcefully implanted in me by 8 white U.S. Immigration and Customs Enforcement, ICE. Let me start by saying that I admit the fact that I overstayed in America. I traveled in April 1997 and became a permanent resident in 2008. Though I went in with a visiting visa, but I got my green card in 2008, February. In between, I used a friend's passport to travel to Nigeria in 2001 because my parents were critically ill, which I know that was wrong. But on getting back, I was not arrested. In 2009, February, I traveled, to Nigeria, and on getting back at the BWI, I was arrested by Officer Derek Dawood. And he questioned me about a passport that belongs to Emmanuel Adegoke. I said I wanted to speak with my lawyer. I wasn't going to lie, but at least let me follow the law. I didn't want to make any incriminating statement, but he refused. And he kept me in a very cold room for 9 hours, from 1 p.m. to about 10 p.m. in the evening. As soon as I made the statement at about 10 p.m., he took me straight to DC jail. I was there for 4 months, and my family and friends got me a lawyer, and the lawyer checked my record and said, "Jacob, you never had any criminal record in America. The judge might be lenient on you because you already made an incriminating statement." So I said, "That's okay." So the judge gave me 6 months for the offense, and she credited me, the judge by name Justice Ellen Uvell, and she credited me for the 4 months that I spent. She said, "Jacob, in 13 years, never had any criminal record. That they want people like me in U.S. Anyway, instead of releasing me on August 5th, 2009, ICE released me on August 11th, 5 days after, which is against the law. 5 days after. And when I was released, I came back from North Carolina to Washington, D.C., and to Maryland on the 12th of August. So I was in my house. On August 17th, Officer Derek Dawood called me again and said, "Jacob, come and pick up your green card and your passport. Don't forget, I'm already a permanent resident." So I got there on August the 19th, as scheduled. Though my lawyer was supposed to meet me at the same time, he gave us 1 o'clock appointment. But I got there before him, and he said I should enter. As soon as I entered, I was arrested and handcuffed. I was like, "This is Jacob." He said, "Yeah, you're under arrest." I said, "What have I done?" He said, "I have to see the judge." I said, "Again? I've already served my time." So then they took me to the back of their counter, and about a few minutes after I saw my lawyer coming, I said, Mr. Johnson, come on." I was beckoning on him to come and, to come and bail me out. And he said he would see me in detention. And so he left, white to white. And I was like, I was worried. What's going on? Then I looked at the officer. I asked him, I said, "What's going to happen?" He said, "I have to see the judge again." I said, "How long?" He said, "Within the next 2-3 days. I spent 1.5 years this time. And the fourth month that I was there, one officer by name William T. Malone came and he said, "Jacob, you can be released." I said, "Officer, what am I doing here?" He said, "No, it was a mistake. They made a mistake to have released me earlier, but he can release me, but it's going to cost me money." I said, "Okay." Meanwhile, I already got another lawyer. They got me another lawyer from whom, this time a Nigerian, a Yoruba lady by name Nife Akimbali. And the lady, I told her what happened, what the officer said, and she called the immigration head office. And they came to interrogate me, and they did all their investigation. So the officer was fired. As soon as the officer was fired, that was the beginning of my torture in America. So they started moving me from one detention to the other. And then December 3rd, 2010, at Frederick Detention Center, I went for a Bible study. On coming back, I just felt something strange in my umbilical cord. And the two other inmates that were with me, I showed them. They said, "Oh, Jacob, this is strange." let's go and see the officers on duty. We got there, and the officers told them to step by. As soon as we were at the corridor, they just crushed me to the floor. So two officers, I saw six other officers join them, and they pulled out my pants, and they inserted something in my anus. I started shouting, but no one could help. You know, then they moved me to the suicide watch. They lied that I wanted to kill myself. And then from there to one doctor, Andrew, and then he was asking me why 2 plus 2. I answered him. From there, I was moved to California. They told me, oh, Jacob, pack your stuff, you are going. I thought I was going back. I was coming back to Nigeria. They moved me from Maryland to San Diego in California. I was wondering, what's going on? And then this time around, when I got there, I saw the point of registering, and then I saw this guy, a black American. And I told him about my ordeal. I said, oh, shit, that's a microchip. That was when I knew that it was microchip they inserted in my body. I said, that thing is just moving all around my body. And then they kept me among the mentally retarded in San Diego. They moved me away from my family, friends, and the Nigerian embassy. And then they moved me from that place to API, the private hospital, API Behavioral Center in San Diego. And I saw the doctor there, Dr. Ishmael Ishak. I said, doctor, I don't want any treatment. I'm not a psychiatric patient. I want to go back to my country. I said, I will take care of me. The following day, he sent his guys. I was handcuffed, my hands and my legs, and they gave me 8 injections for 4 days, one in the morning, one in the evening for 4 days. On the fifth day, the doctor came, and I said, doctor, why would you force your guys on me? Oh, I was talking at the top of my voice, and he had his entourage with him. I said, look, why would you force your... He said, Jacob, relax. He's following instruction. I said, how will you follow instruction? Are you supposed to follow instruction or your profession? You went through the 4 walls of university just like I did. So, you know, the others were wondering what's going on. So the doctor said, what do you want? I said, I want to go back to Nigeria. And then 2 days after, you know, he said I should pack my stuff, that I was going back to Nigeria. I was very happy. I came on voluntary deportation. And then at the airport, they tried to bypass the scanner and all that. We got to Ghana. And, you know, from Ghana, they refused to show my boarding pass. You know, the lady was asking them, said it got lost in the plane. And she left. The guy said, please, on my honor. So we passed through Ghana's port without a passport. I, as a passenger. Anyway, when we go to Nigeria, I narrated everything to the Nigerian immigration. Then they told me to see the SSS. And from there, you know, they documented everything, said it would get back to me. Until date, I've not heard anything. You know, so as soon as I got back to Nigeria, you know, we started my family, we started moving from one diagnosis center to the other, but we couldn't detect this thing because it's hidden from, you know, from Africans, even from black Americans, you know. So, you know, there was a time that some Indians came to Nigeria and, you know, they were able to detect where it is in my body, and that thing is still there till date. And I want this microchip removed from my body. I'm calling on everyone that can be of assistance. Please, you know, America should obey human rights laws. You know, this is an abuse of the highest order. Thank you.